This is Ron Valdiserri reporting from the 2015 National Summit on HCV and HIV. And I am delighted to be joined by my colleague, Dr. John Ward, who heads up viral hepatitis programs at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Welcome, John.
Thank you, Ron.
I wonder if you could share with our audience what steps CDC has taken recently to improve rates of testing and diagnosis for chronic viral hepatitis C.
Well, testing is very important, first of all. We have 3 million people infected with hepatitis C. At least half of those people are unaware of it, and that's the first step in getting those people into the care and treatment that they need. So we're approaching increasing that proportion. You know their status in a number of different ways. First, we have an education campaign that we call No More Hepatitis, K-N-O-W, play on words, to emphasize the importance of testing for people who are baby boomers, a target population, those born between 1945 and 1965, as well as other populations at risk. We have a provider education program that's trying to help all providers understand the importance of offering that test to these target populations. And we're also trying to make it easier for providers to offer that test, such as putting in what's called clinical decision prompts. So when someone...
So what does that mean for the non-clinicians listening to this?
So that means when a patient checks in to the clinic and their birth year falls within that 1945 to 1965 time span, then there is a electronic reminder sent to that clinician to order the test
through,
for that
through
patient.
The medical record.
Through the electronic medical record. And that's been shown in the VA and the Indian Health Service and some other large health systems to be very effective in increasing
Great.
Testing.
For consumers or potential patients who might be listening to us, can you tell us briefly about the two-step testing process?
Sure. The goal of testing is to determine whether someone has the infection or not.
Current infection.
Current infection. The virus is living in their body and causing their liver harm in many cases. So the first test is just an antibody test that just detects the antibody that lets the provider know this person has been exposed to the virus. And then you need a second test that's a little more complicated. That's why it's done only on those who have evidence of having been exposed. To actually detect the virus. So in many laboratories, they use the same blood draw to run both of those tests, and in some settings, you may have to come back and get blood a second time.
Now, I want to switch topics a bit and ask you to talk about hepatitis C elimination. More and more, I'm hearing people talk about the elimination of hepatitis C. What do folks mean by that, and why is that a topic that's starting to come to light now?
Well, it reflects the great excitement over these curative treatments that we now have, that with just one to several pills taken a day for, on average, 12 weeks, you can achieve over a 90% cure of hepatitis C infection with very few side effects. So it's a very tolerable, very safe, highly effective regimen that results in cure in over 90% of the time. So people are now thinking, well, with that degree of impact, we can eliminate infection and the deaths that unfortunately are continuing to rise in the United States from hepatitis C. And I think that's a very attractive goal. But we have to recognize what needs to be brought together in terms of capacity to make that happen. We still don't have enough providers offering the test. We don't have enough providers who are trained in providing the care and treatment that's needed. We don't have the surveillance systems at the moment to quickly detect new transmissions so that we can get out in front of this epidemic that we're experiencing of new hepatitis C transmissions. And the drug costs continue to be formidable, and we have to get the drug cost in line with the with the dollars available to really address elimination.
So we really appreciate your time and your insights, Dr. Ward. Keep
My
up
pleasure.
The great work at CDC. This
Thank
is
you.
Ron Valdiserri reporting from the 2015 National Summit.